about the priesthood, of course, and celibacy and so forth. One of the things that I found most most interesting myself, and that I think many married men, especially, but also women, sort of reading it in the light of spiritual motherhood, found very helpful, is the recognition that what binds us all together as Christians is this call to give life. And men do that in the nature of fatherhood, and women in the nature of motherhood, which are obviously distinct, complementary, but also both very powerful ways of giving life and living out our vocation, our common vocation, our baptismal vocation to give life. And some are called out from that in order to give life in a particular way as priests and as religious and in other ways. But that all of us are called to be spiritual mothers and fathers. St. John Paul II said it was actually a mark of spiritual maturity that we recognize our own call to become a spiritual father and a spiritual mother. And that recognition is something that I think unites all of us, whether single, young, old, married, priest, really, it doesn't matter. That if we sort of, each of us looks in at our own vocation, and that when we're faithful to our vocation, finding ways that we can give life to those around us, and that Jesus wants to do that through us, I couldn't agree more. That it's through prayer and that domestic church and sort of finding that common bond, that it's not sort of the job of the priest, you know, and it's not the job of the religious. It's not that we're in this family together, and that all of us have that call to give life in the order of grace.